My name is Javier Medina, and the title of my contribution is Growing Seedlings in a Random Positioning Machine under a Photoperiod Regime Promotes Plant Adaptation to Microgravity Environment by Restoring Meristematic Competence. Plants live in dynamic environments with frequent changes in many parameters, such as temperature, humidity, water, and light. Since plants are sessile organisms, they have developed different directional responses to modulate their growth according to environmental cues, which are termed tropisms. The two major tropistic cues are gravity and light. Plant development, driven by tropistic cues, is supported by the activity of the meristematic tissues. These tissues are characterized by the balance between cells actively proliferating, involved in a continuous cell cycle, and the cells escaping from the cell cycle to differentiate. In fact, meristems constitute the source of cells for growth and differentiation, being the cellular basis for the developmental program of the plant. Meristematic cells are undifferentiated, highly proliferating cells, which maintain a strict coordination between cell proliferation and cell growth, which is termed meristematic competence. For the establishment of the meristematic competence, the phytohormone auxin plays a key role. It is known that gravitropic signals influence the auxin polar transport in the root. Auxin is ultimately responsible of the process of gravitropies, by which the growth is oriented according to the gravity vector. Auxin is also the main regulator of the function of the root meristematic cells, that is, cell growth and cell proliferation, whose coordination produces meristematic competence. Therefore, auxin is the mediator between sensing of gravity signals and the effects of these signals on development at the level of the meristematic tissue. We know that microgravity, as it exists in spaceflight, disrupts meristematic competence by altering the regulation of the cell cycle, producing an acceleration of the cycle and an increase of the proliferation rate. At the same time, cell growth is depleted, as shown by changes in the levels of nuclear proteins and in the expression of genes regulating the production of ribosomes. The hypothesis of this work was to test whether or not light is able of counteracting the adverse effects produced by microgravity on meristematic cells. Light is the factor responsible of phototropism, which together with gravitropism drive the growth of plants. At the same time, light influences many morphogenetic processes throughout the entire life of the plant, so that photomorphogenesis is a major developmental event. In this line, we have performed the seedling growth project in the International Space Station. In this series of experiments, we have studied the interaction between light and gravity sensing in spaceflight conditions and the combined influence of these factors on cell growth and proliferation in the root meristem of seedlings grown in space. Among our results, we have found that red light irradiation was capable of reverting the altered pattern of gene expression that was caused by microgravity in spaceflight. Now, we have used the random positioning machine, a reliable facility for microgravity simulation on Earth, to test the effects of a white light photoperiod. Several genotypes and lines of Arabidopsis were used, namely the wild type, two mutants of the two genes of the nuclear protein nucleolin, and a reported line for the detection of auxin in situ. They were incubated in the RPM, grown under photoperiod, and analyzed for several parameters relevant for the status of meristematic competence. You can see here images of seedlings grown in the experimental conditions used, grown under photoperiod, in the RPM, or in the 1G control, and grown in darkness, also in simulated microgravity or in 1G. Seedlings show their roots oriented in the direction of the gravity vector and opposite to light source, positive gravitropism and negative phototropism. Hypocotyls were oriented opposite to gravity and, in the case of illumination, towards the top light source, that is negative gravitropism and positive phototropism. Simulated microgravity samples with photoperiod regime presented the same orientation as in 1G control samples, except for a slight disorganization of the roots. Samples grown in darkness and microgravity without any tropistic cues, showing an apparent random growth of roots of and hypocotyls. A slight antigravitropic preferential direction of the roots was detected in the NUG1 mutant and even less pronounced in the wild type, but not in the NUG2 mutant. In the case of hypocotyls, the antigravitropic growth was more evident in all genotypes, but the growth direction was never coincident with the vertical axis. A conspicuous skewing of hypocotyls in the conditions of action of light and gravity was observed. This effect was especially relevant for the wild-type seedlings, in which hypocotyls showed a sort of parallel alignment, and it appeared relatively attenuated in the two mutant lines. It is noteworthy that this skewness of hypocotyls was restricted to the conditions of microgravity and darkness, and it did not appear in any other condition. The activity of ribosome biogenesis is an accurate estimation of the rate of cell growth, since it is directly correlated with the synthesis of proteins. A decisive step in ribosome biogenesis is the processing of the primary transcript of ribosomal genes, the 45S pre-RNA. The efficiency of this processing in roots was analyzed by RNA quantification at both ends of the transcript, the 5' ETS and the 3' ETS, and by quantification of 25 RNA by RT-qPCR. Quantification of terminal RNA sequences of the primary transcript could serve to detect alterations in early steps of the process, whereas different levels of the 25S RNA, one of the terminal products of the process, would indicate a general alteration of ribosome biogenesis. When the seedlings grew in the RPM with photoperiod regime, the 25S RNA showed a greater accumulation for all genotypes, wild type, NUG1, and NUG2. However, sequences at both ends of the primary transcript only appeared accumulated in wild type and NUG2 mutant, but they appear reduced in the NUG1 mutant. Comparisons were done in all cases with respect to the 1G control. On the other hand, in seedlings subjected to microgravity without light, the ETS pre-RNA accumulation was different for the two ends. For 5' ETS, it was higher in wild type, but lower in the NUG1 mutant, whereas the 3' ETS stream showed a lower level in the two mutant lines, NUG1 and NUG2, when compared to levels obtained for the corresponding 1G control. The 25S RNA accumulation was statistically greater in the NUG2 mutant in comparison with the 1G control condition. In summary, photoperiod reverts the effects of microgravity on the processing of preribosomal RNA, which is decisive for the accurate production of ribosomes and consequently for protein synthesis and cell growth. The T2 Venus transgenic reported line was used for analyzing the auxin distribution pattern in the distal part of the root under simulated microgravity for the two light conditions, by comparing the pattern shown in this condition with that observed in the 1G control condition. Note that in the reported line, fluorescence staining indicates the absence of auxin. The fluorescence pattern obtained in seedlings subjected to simulated microgravity and photoperiod regime was essentially similar to the control pattern of seedlings at 1G, in which no lateral imbalance or alteration in auxin distribution in the root was observed. On the contrary, the fluorescent pattern obtained in samples grown in simulated microgravity and darkness showed a lower signal intensity in the meristematic cell layers, the central cylinder and the columella cells compared with the 1G control. Indicating that the lack of gravity stimulus alters the auxin distribution in the root. More auxin is accumulated in the distal part of the root, indicating that the transport of this phytohormone is altered or even inhibited. In general, the intensity of labeling was higher in the samples grown with photoperiod than in the samples grown in darkness. This means that whatever the gravity conditions, culture in darkness induced by itself some accumulation of oxygen in the root tip, which appears increased in simulated microgravity. Therefore, we can postulate that photoperiod reverts the alteration of oxygen polar transport in the root as detected with the D2-Venus reported line. Finally, we have performed a transcriptomic study by RT-qPCR with RNA extracted from roots. The analysis investigated in the different conditions of gravity and light used the expression changes of three sets of genes selected as markers of these functions. The first set was composed of two genes involved in oxygen polar transport, the gene AIR, and in the oxygen perception, the gene TIR. The second set was composed of the genes indicator of cell proliferation status, since they are involved in cell cycle regulation, the cyclin B1 and the casein kinase 2. Finally, the third set was composed of genes involved in the regulation of ribosome biogenesis, nuclearin 1, nuclearin 2, and fibrillarin, hence indicators of cell growth status. The analysis of the relative expression of the genes in siglings of the three lines grown under simulated microgravity and photoperiod regime compared with the 1G control condition showed that the gravity alteration produces a general downregulation, differently affecting the concerned function and the different lines. The oxygen polar transport was altered as indicated by the decrease of the AIR gene expression in all lines. Also in the NUC1 mutant, a pronounced decrease in the expression of the oxygen receptor TIR was produced. The expression of the cyclin B1 gene also experienced a marked decrease in simulated microgravity conditions in the wild type and in both mutant lines, NUC1 and NUC2. In contrast, the CK2 expression was only detected as significantly decreased in the NUC1 mutant. In turn, the expression of the cell growth markers showed less clear changes, only a decrease of the NUC2 gene for NUC1 mutant and an increase of 5 gene for NUC2 mutant reaches a statistical significance, while no alteration of any of these markers was produced in the wild type line. The results in the dark conditions showed in general the opposite trend. The oxygen transport markers were altered in simulated microgravity and darkness as shown by the general increase in the TIR gene expression. An increase in the expression of A gene was produced only in the NUC2 mutant. In the case of cell proliferation markers, the cyclin B1 gene showed a decrease of the expression in NUC1 mutant, but an increase in the NUC2, whereas the expression of CK2 appeared only incremented significantly in the wild-type plants. The expression of all cell growth markers, nucleolin 1 and 2 and fibrillarin, was upregulated when compared with 1G control in nucleolin mutant line. Overall upregulation only reached statistical significance in the fibrillarin in the NUC2 mutant. Therefore, photoperiod reverts the alteration in the expression of relevant marker genes, acting as regulators of the oxygen transport, of cell cycle regulation, and of ribosome biogenesis. In conclusion, light is a signal capable of rescuing disrupted meristematic competence at early developmental stages, as it was described in the absence of the two main tropistic cues that drive and regulate growth on Earth, namely light and gravity. This is decisive for the long-term success of plant development. The incorporation of an illumination regime, in this case photoperiod, has been sufficient to attenuate or suppress the effects caused by gravitational stress, such that plants can grow and develop correctly in microgravity, showing only alterations at the molecular level, but no changes detectable at the cellular level. Therefore, and as shown by other experiments carried out at real and simulated microgravity, if the growth conditions are optimal in terms of the supply of nutrients like temperature and humidity, the plants present at correct growth in their first stages of development. Despite that, molecular alterations are still compatible with the expected adaptation mechanisms involving the modulation of duplicated and specialized genes expressed under environmental stress, such as the nuclearin 2, that should be promoted to increase the plant acclimation to a new extraterrestrial environment. Therefore, in order to go deeper in our knowledge of the crosstalks between these two environmental signals, Future experiments focused on signaling and transduction of both cues are necessary. Emphasis should be put in the central role of auxin in the signaling mechanisms and in answering questions that were left unanswered, such as the lack of alteration in the auxin distribution pattern at the root tip. Funding for this work has been provided by the Spanish Research Agency of the Spanish government and the access to the random positioning machine of the University of Toulouse by the Ground-Based Facilities Program of the European Space Agency. Thank you very much.